It's the 1860s of New York City in early America. There lived a man named Dick who was homeless, about 14 years of age, and he slept on the streets. He didn't really have much other than his wooden box that he used tape to help make money by shining the shoes of many people. But then one day, Dick meets Mr. Whitney, a very wealthy man. Mr. Whitney asks Dick if he can show his nephew, Frank, the whole city of New York, which Frank does. Dick and Frank go on a whole bunch of adventures, and they see all sorts of things in New York City. I don't want to spoil too much, but this is the original story of Rags to Riches. This book was written by Horatio Alger Jr., who was born on January 13th, way back in 1832. He was an American writer of mainly young adult novels about disadvantaged boys and their rise from humble backgrounds to a middle eight-class success. His writings were characterized by the rags-to-riches narrative. Alger has written over 100 poems and over 100 storybooks, most notably Ragged Dick. So one of my favorite excerpts from Ragged Dick is the first time we see Dick make business. So, how much, asked a gentleman on his way to his office. 10 cents, said Dick, dropping his box and sinking upon his knees on the sidewalk, flourishing his brush with the air of one skilled in his profession. 10 cents, isn't that a little steep, said the man. Well, you know, I gotta make a clear profit, said Dick, who was already set to work. There's the blacking cost, something that I have to get a new brush pretty often. And you have a large rent, too, said the gentleman, with a glance at the large hole on Dick's coat. Yes, sir, said Dick, always ready to joke. I have to pay such a big rent for my mansion up on Fifth Street, you know. I can't afford to take a less than 10 cents a shine. I'll give you a bully shine, sir. Okay, be quick about it, for I am in a hurry. So your house is on Fifth Avenue, is it? It is. It isn't anywhere else, said Dick, spoke the truth there. What tailor do you patronize, asked the gentleman, surveying Dick's attire. Would you like to go to the same one, asked Dick, jokingly. Well, no. It strikes me that he didn't give you a very good fit. This coat once belonged to General Washington, said Dick comically. He wore it all throughout the Revolution, and it got torn some, because he fit so hard. When he died, he told his soldiers to give it to some smart young fellow that hadn't gotten none of his own. So, she gave it to me. But if you like it, sir, to remind yourself of General Washington, I'll give you it for a reasonable price. Thank you. I'm going to have to pass, said the man. And did your pants also come from General Washington, asked the man. Well, no. That was a gift from Louis Napoleon. Louis had outgrown him and sent him to me. He's bigger than me, and they just didn't fit right on him. It seems you have some distinguished friends, said the man. Now, my lad, I suppose you would like your money. I shouldn't have any objection, said Dick. So here we can really see the comicalness of Dick and how sociable and how he can really connect with people.